Here comes the money. You're now listening to the Gambling with Gold podcast with Jason Gold, presented by Champions Round.
The Sunday Super Wildcard Weekend Parlay. We got six games on the board. No, we got three games on the board. We're putting in six bets. We're putting together a sick parlay. Let's get right to it. First game of the day on the board is going to be the Miami Dolphins, who are plus 13 at the Buffalo Bills. Total set at 43.5. Looks like this one is going to be Skylar Thompson from all the information that I see right now, which is kind of sort of unbelievable. Also, seems like Damar Hamlin is going to be on the field in some capacity for the Bills. So Bills by 10 billion points. That's what we're doing here, right?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. And I mean, the Bills could hit this over like on their own. This game could get out of control really fast, I think. I personally don't want a lot to do with this game just because of that. I like the Bills to cover. I don't think that they're – I mean, Skylar Thompson, this is ridiculous. Like, we're getting Skylar Thompson against the Buffalo Bills, who have been dominant for the most part of this season. Josh Allen averaged like 350 passing yards, 7 TDs, and no interceptions against the Dolphins in the two regular season matchups. I do, however, like Josh Allen to throw an interception at plus 132. You know, everyone knows I like to have trends, and he hasn't thrown one yet against them. How about he gives one to them here? But that's how Miami can stay in this game, would have to be defensively. So they're going to have to play very hard. But yeah, I don't see the Miami Dolphins standing a chance.
Yeah, let's just do it. We'll keep it easy. Buffalo minus 13. We'll take the over 43.5, assuming that Miami can put up a couple points, but that Buffalo's probably going to put up a 35 spot real quick in this one. Yeah. Hopefully we can get the over 43.5. I think 35-10, 35-14 seems like a good final score for this one. Buffalo's just going to, like, they're going to find a way to get to 35 in this game. It's just the way that it's going to happen. Divisional opponent in Buffalo after what's happened the last couple of weeks, I think that they absolutely come out here and dominate. No reason for them to take their foot off the gas. My actual favorite play in this game would probably be Buffalo first half, because I just think they're going to come out and absolutely light it on fire. All right, let's get to, you know what? I want to save your game for last. So we're going to go to the night game. We're going to go to Ravens-Bengals. Bengals minus 9, total set at 40.5 right now. Looks like it's probably going to be Anthony Brown or Tyler Huntley. Lamar probably out. I would say that's safe to assume. Tyler Huntley is dealing with tendonitis in his shoulder, so not sure he's going to be able to go. He hasn't practiced. He might be able to play, but do you really want to put a quarterback into a playoff game when they haven't been able to practice? I don't know. So that leaves Anthony Brown. Not great. Bengals are rolling right now. What do you think? Because I think that I know what I want to do in this game, but I want to hear your opinion first.
I'm very torn on this game. It's so funny because this number would look totally different if Lamar was playing. I kind of lean the over in this game too, just because I think it could get out of control, similar to the Bills-Miami game. Ravens D does play hard, so part of me thinks that the Ravens could randomly cover this game, maybe the Bengals slow down, but I'm just going to trust my gut here and roll with the Bengals. No Lamar. Ravens are in a bad spot.
So you don't think that there's any shot? Just because this is a divisional game, these two teams hate each other. Whatever happened last week was just Harbaugh doing nothing to show the Bengals anything. But the Bengals have been rolling. This is where I'm confused, because yes, if it's Anthony Brown, no one wants any part of this line. And this line might close at 10, 11. I don't really know how high this could go. But also, it's all public money. This Ravens defense, let's not forget, is one of the best units in the NFL. I think that they will come to compete in this game. I like this under 40.5 a lot. And I'm kind of leaning towards the Ravens. The only reason, you know, for the purposes of the parlay, I'm okay with putting it in at plus 9. But I'm going to wait until pretty much kickoff and see how high this thing goes, because I think it could be a lot higher.
Could this end up being – like, it wouldn't shock me if this score ends up being like a 17-13 type game. Like, I wouldn't be – that would not surprise me, because I think defensively the Ravens can stay in this game, and I think they are going to come hard. We've seen the Bengals in some positions where their O-line has played better, but it's still not that strong. And you see what happens when Burrow does get some pressure on him. He's played fantastic. But this divisional game could get a little weird too. And this number, like you said, is going to get ridiculous. Like, I think I'm comfortable still taking the Bengals at, is it plus nine right now?
Yeah, it's plus or minus nine for the Bengals.
Minus nine, right. But that number is going to go up. So I don't know. Once it starts getting 10, 11, this number is going to get ridiculous at some point if Lamar is officially ruled out. So I probably wouldn't, I would lean Ravens that when it does. But right now, I think I'm with you. I feel comfortable taking the nine.
You know what? Screw it. There's a money line available on this site right now. So minus 445. You want to just throw that in? Easy leg.
Sure. Let's do it.
All right. Let's do that. All right. So our first four picks for the Sunday parlay is going to be Miami, Buffalo over 43.5, Buffalo minus 13, the Bengals money line minus 445, and the under 40.5 in that game. All right. Let's get to quote unquote the game of the day, the game of the century in the Smallest household. We got the New York Giants plus 3 at the Minnesota Vikings. Total set at 48 in this game. Vikings minus 165 on the money line. Giants at plus 145. I want to get this out of the way to start. I don't care. I'm going to let you make the decision on Giants plus 3 or Vikings minus 3. We are taking the under 48 in this game. That line
what
is completely
mean?
It is completely ridiculous to expect the Giants to play in a playoff game and expect an over 48 in this game. The Vikings offense has been worse. The Giants offense can't do shit. We are taking the under 48 in this game. We're taking the under.
Oh my God, I hate that. But whatever. Yes, that's fine.
Why do you like the over so much?
I just think that this game, again, these teams match up better than everyone realizes. I don't give a fuck what the Vikings record is. It's so funny, all these Vikings fans like in my mentions, like you guys are gonna get, we're not, no one, if you watch football, you know neither of these teams is blowing the other one out. So it's either gonna be a match defensively, and if that's the case, I think the Giants win because I think their defense is better than the Vikings defense. If it comes down to offense, I think Jones is going to be the key factor here. Daniel Jones is everything this game. If he can, like I said yesterday, I think he rushes for a shitload of yards. I actually was just listening to the Sports Gambling Podcast, and Brandon Jacobs said for over 80 rushing yards too. Now I feel more confident in my lock. But I think that, you know, I think the Giants cover again. We saw what these teams did. This is going to end up being a close game. We can take the under though. Maybe there isn't as many points scored. Maybe you're right.
Well, if we're going to take the Giants, it is correlated to the Giants plus, or sorry, if we're going to take the Giants plus 3, it is correlated to the under. So if we want to do both of those, mm-hmm. I'm down with it. Let's get with the get down, or mm-hmm. we could get super spicy and just say, fuck it. Let's just do Giants money line plus 145 and get the hell out of here.
We could. Okay. So then there's another, I know you like half money lines too. So I was looking into it. Giants have the third worst time of possession in the first half, second best in the second half. So we could take Vikings first half money line or Giants second half money line too.
Whoa.
Did I just blow
okay.
your mind a little bit there?
Yeah, a little bit. All right. So let me try to get this in here. So
I'm interested.
We got to go back to the board, people. This never
happened. We gotta go back. We gotta recap. I waited to tell you this until we were on the show.
No, I love it. All right, so let's see if we can throw in the first half money line here. So you want to do Vikings
first
half? It would
be Vikings first half, Giants or Giants second half.
All right, so I can only do the first half here. So Vikings first half minus 150 money line, and then we take Giants plus 3 for the game, and the under 48.5. And we just have 7 plays. All right, which player are we getting rid of? We got to get rid of a play.
Okay.
Let's get rid of the Bengals Baltimore total.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see if they'll let me. Oh, they won't let me do the correlated.
Son of a biscuit.
All right, we're putting the Bengals total back. Giants plus 3. Under 48. Let's ride. All right, so just so that we're aware, if you can do that somewhere, Vikings to win the first half, Giants to win the second half. Steph likes that bet. Vikings to win the first half outright. Giants to win the game, also kind of like that play. Steph also likes Daniel Jones over rushing. I believe the number you said yesterday is 38.5 to start off with.
It is. Right? I think it's now. I think there's only one spot you can get that. I looked before we got on. and it's up to like 40.5, I still would take it. Like, I would take it as, like I said, I would go crazy with this number. Also interesting, I'm going to get spicy. I wasn't going to share this, but I'm going to fucking share it because we're on the show. I don't know what Justin Jefferson's receiving yards are, but I like his under, whatever it is. This year, if you go take a look at Mr. Jefferson's stats, when he sees a team for the second time, they actually shut him down entirely. He has 100-plus yard games. The first matchup, then the second matchup, they get shut down, and the Vikings lose that game. Very interesting seeing the Giants for the second time. If that will stay true, I don't know, but I would be comfortable taking Jefferson's under. And I would do that with any second matchup. Not just that it's the Giants, just that that is what the trend says to me.
I actually love that play. Now, I don't really want to get in front of Jefferson that much, but the idea that, you know, they've seen the scheme once and they figured out how to cover Jefferson. Yes, he's still an elite player, but they have a scheme for it. I'm all in on that angle there. All right, so our Sunday wild card weekend parlay is going to look like this. We're going to put $100 on Buffalo minus 13, the over 43.5 in Dolphins Bills, Giants plus 3, the Giants under 48, Ravens under 40.5, and the Bengals money line minus 445, which is dumb, but whatever. risking $100 to win $2,941. That is our Sunday parlay for Wild Card Weekend.